This is an example of how to do number 74 on the CST Algebra Release Test question packet. In this problem, it states that an object is being thrown straight downward with an initial velocity v feet per second, and it's going a distance s equals vt plus 16t squared. This formula is going to be very important to solving the problem. T is going to represent our time in seconds. So Ramon is standing on a balcony 84 feet above the ground. If we go ahead and draw Ramon, it gives us a better idea of what the problem's looking for. And 84 feet is how far up he is. He throws a penny straight down with an initial velocity of 10 feet per second. So what the problem's looking for is how many seconds will it take for it to reach the ground? So let's go ahead and look at the information that we have. First is the equation, s equals vt plus 16t squared. This is a very complex problem to be able to solve without any numbers. Well, fortunately, it provides us with two numbers. The first one is 84 feet above the ground. So the distance that this penny is going to travel from the top of the balcony to the bottom of the building is going to be 84 feet. The initial velocity is going to be 10 feet per second. So from here, we have a quadratic equation that we need to solve. So we subtract 84 on both sides of the equation and reorganize. We end up with 16t squared plus 10t minus 84. Okay. Now, the next thing is to be able to factor anything out of each term that we can. I see that there's a 2 that can be factored out of each pair, or each set. To give me 8t squared plus 5t minus 42. Now from here, we need to be able to break down and set up the factors. We know that one of them is going to be positive, one of them is going to be negative. What tells us this is the minus 42. What else we know is we can set up a Fleto chart to find the value that's going to work out best for us. So we can take 8 times 1. 4 times 2, we can take 2 times 4, or 1 times 8. And we're trying to get the last term to equal negative 42, so 6 times negative 7, 7 times negative 6. I know that 42 times 1 and 1 times 42 are going to be out just because we're looking for a number that's a positive 5. So I can also put in 21 times negative 2, or 2 times negative 21. Now, trying to find the one that works the best is going to be fairly simple in this case. Because if I take 8 times 6, or 8 times 7, that's going to give me way too big of a number. Same thing with 7 and negative 6. So let's try 8 times 21, 1 times negative 2. 8 times 21 is 168. That's a far cry from the 5 that we're looking for. What about 8 times 2 and 1 times negative 21? -16 minus 21 equals a negative 5, which is very close to the answer that we're looking for. So let's switch the signs. Eight times negative 2 is 16. 1 times 21 is 21. Adding them together gets me 5. So I know that one term is going to be 8t. I know that another term is going to be a positive t, or 1t. And I know that my 8 has to be multiplied by negative 2. Well, it's going to be in this space here. 1 times 21 goes here. Now I'm going to create two cases to figure out which one is the correct answer. Set both of them equal to 0 and solve. Dividing both sides by 8, end up getting negative 21 over 8. This doesn't make sense because we cannot have a negative time that something travels. Our only other option is setting t minus 2 equal to 0. And this is a positive number. If we check it out, we see that A is 2 seconds. This is the correct answer for number 74.